Hello friends, in this video I'll be showing you practically how we can assign any of the selected column from the scorecard to a text box or any other component. So suppose let me run this. This is one of the simple scorecard which I created. So what is this is so this is just a text scorecard, sample scorecard. If we click on this, if we select any of this column, then this value should be populated in another text box, like this one or this one. Like first column value should be in this first text box, the second column value should be in the second. So there may be some requirement where we need to populate based on the user selection. So when we create a dashboard, at that time we user may wanted to see some of the specific values from here to another text box, or maybe hierarchical levels like that. So let's see how we can do this. So on select of this, we can write a script where we can set some values from this scorecard to a text box. So just select this scorecard, and in the properties there is a new events on select. Click on this. So here you need to write some code which will get the selection of the scorecard first. So I am just adding this code. So what this code is doing, like this, first we will take a variable which will get the scorecard selection. Means whatever the rows users are selecting, so the first row or second row, means whatever. So that we will get in a variable. So as this is a array, it is not a single value, right? So it is an array based. So we need to apply the for each statement for this. So select scorecard dot for each, then we will see function value key. So now this set text one, text underscore one dot set text and the value of zero. So if we apply this, so what happens, like if we apply this, then and just run it. So let's see means what happens. So if you see this, though I am clicking on this, it is assigning this value to this technology, which is this one. So like this, if we click on this, technology of the suppliers. So the second row which is there, which is the dimension, it gets assigned to this. So what if you wanted to assign this particular value, this column to one text box, this first text box, and this value to another text box. So how we can do this? So let's do it. Means for that, for this scorecard, there is an additional properties. And if you see this column one, so there is a name like for this header. Like it is zcust name. So I'll just copy this zcust name. Or for column two, it is pro category, product category. So what I'll do, I'll just go to the script again, and I'll just say in the for loop, for each statement, what I'll do, I'll write a statement, if statement, where I will say if key is equal to Z customer. So that means it is a first statement, first column of the scorecard. Then it is assigning to text one dot set text value. Okay. So this way, what it will do, whatever the values it is there, so we'll from the first column it is getting assigned to the second, means this first text box. So let's see how it works. So now you see, means if I click on this, so all these are like, let's see, means I'm going to see. Now if I click on this, this is getting reflected here. Okay, let's see now. So though I'm clicking on here, but it is not assigning this value. So now what we can do, we can assign the same value to this text box and this value can to another text box. So now let's see how we can do this. So again we can write a if statement where it says like which is the other second column name, and again we can say the same statement but to the text 2, and I'll just say okay. So now if I run this, now you'll see there is a change in the report output, where if you click on the first column, wherever we click, for first it is assigning to the first text, for second column this is assigning to the second column. So let's like this. Okay, so this way it is how it is, you can say. Okay, so this is how we can achieve this, means from a scorecard to another text box where we can implement this. So I hope you have understood this. If you have any questions, then please put it in the comment section. If you like my video, then please like it and please subscribe to my channel as well. And don't forget to click on that bell icon so that you will get notified about my next video about this Design Studio, as I'll be going to post about the new practical examples like this only for each and scenarios I'm getting. So. Yep, if you like my video, then please like it, and thank you for watching.